The test of Akash NG, new generation, was conducted by the Indian Army and the Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, in the Pokhran Field Firing Range in Rajasthan's Jaisalmer district. Akash NG is an upgrade of the original Akash system. The missile, which has been designed for the use of the Indian Air Force (IAF) and the Indian Army, can intercept high-maneuvering aerial threats. Currently, India has deployed 9 Akash mobile batteries for air defense. The upgraded Akash NG will improve the military's capability to take down threats, including those posed by the enemy's stealth fighter jets. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why India's Akash NG would be deadly for Pakistani jets, drones, and cruise missiles. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. A successor missile with a new design, Akash New Generation, abbreviated as Akash NG, was approved in September 2016. With a funding of 470 rupees crore to succeed legacy Akash with improved capabilities. Akash NG was conceptualized to have improved reaction time and a higher level of protection against saturation attacks. The latest test is the culmination of this undertaking. The first test flight of original Akash missile was conducted in 1990, with development flights up till March 1997. 2 Akash missiles intercepted 2 fast-moving targets in simultaneous engagement mode in 2005. The Akash missile development cost of 1,000 rupees crore, about 150 million euros or $200 million, including the project sanction of 600 rupees crore, 90 million euros or $120 million, is 8 to 10 times lower than the cost of similar system developments in other countries. In a tweet, the Indian Army's Southwestern Command said, "With surgical precision and lethality, Akash weapon system destroys highly maneuverable, high-speed aerial target, adopting challenging profiles, another milestone added to its legacy as one of the most potent SR-SAM systems." According to an official source, the launch met all the test objectives by performing high maneuvers during the trajectory. As per some reports, a defense source said, "The performance of the command and control system, onboard avionics, and aerodynamic configuration of the missile was successfully validated during the trial. Several range instruments, including radar, EOTS, and telemetry systems, were used while monitoring the entire path of the missile during the test launch." The source said that during the test launch, the entire flight path of the missile was monitored and the flight data was captured by various range instruments. It was further added, "The Akash NG system has been developed with better deployability compared to other similar systems. The missile is solely designed by DRDO and has been produced by Defense PSU Bharat Electronics Ltd. BEL. Akash uses multiple radars like the Russian S-400 air defense system. The 3D central acquisition radar automatically starts tracking targets at a distance of around 150 kilometers or 93 miles, providing early warning to the system and operators. The target track information is transferred to Group Control Center, which automatically classifies the target and sends information to Battery Surveillance Radar. Battery Surveillance Radar starts tracking targets around a range of 100 kilometers or 62 miles. This data is transferred back to Group Control Center, which relays target position information to the battery level radar. The battery level radar is named Rajendra, which is a phased array fire control radar with a tracking range of about 60 kilometers or about 37 miles. It can track 64 targets in range, azimuth, and height, and guide 8 missiles simultaneously in ripple fire mode towards 4 targets. The radar has advanced ECCM features. Viewers may note that electronic countermeasures, or ECCM, are a part of electronic warfare, which includes a variety of practices which attempt to reduce or eliminate the effect of electronic countermeasures, ECM, on electronic sensors. Akash NG system introduced an AESA, or Active Electronically Scanned Array, radar. The AESA is a more advanced, sophisticated, second generation of the original PESA, phased array technology. One of the key advantages of the new Akash NG SAM is that it's powered by a brand new rocket motor instead of the old ramjet that powered the legacy Akash missile. It's a two-pulse solid rocket motor that has the ability to generate a high terminal velocity to outperform even the fastest and most agile enemy fighter jets. A DRDO scientist involved in the project had earlier said, "When the second pulse motor is fired, the Akash NG speeds up and no enemy aircraft can get away." The range of Akash NG is also increased, 80 kilometers or 50 miles, compared to 30 kilometers or 19 miles of legacy Akash. The missile also has optical proximity fuse, which reduces the chances of near misses. It's estimated that this increases the lethality of the weapon by 5 times as compared to older fuses. Akash NG provides India with the defensive capability against different airborne threats. The important aspect is that it's indigenously built, and its further development could improve this system even more. It could be deployed in border regions or in important military bases to counter enemy fighters or drones. The increased range, coupled with enhanced terminal speed and better targeting capacity, makes Akash NG a deadly threat for Pakistani and Chinese aerial assets. The system is poised to become an important anti-access area denial system from India's perspective. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.